What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Astral SMP. Hold on a second. What? What's Astral SMP? What, you ask? Well, this is the rebirth of Addy's Realm, but this time with more friends. And it's been changed so that it's less focused on Addy, because Addy decided, well, you know what, the server's not about me anymore, alright? It's about all the people playing. So it's been rebranded, alright? Now we've got this Astral SMP thing, and, you know, I would love to say, right, let's start from the very beginning, but as you can see, I've got myself a horse, I got myself a nice shiny helmet, and, you know, got some diamonds, got a fair amount of gear here, basically. Had a little bit of a mess up here. So, I've recorded quite a lot, but I messed up all the audio. So, unfortunately, all of it's unusable. Every last bit of the content that I got is absolutely unusable, which is a shame. But you know what? It gives me a fresh start and gives me a more focused look and what I'm going to be doing. So, I mean, it's a shame because I had some really funny content and some really good stuff going on. But, fresh start, you know, it's always appreciated. I've only played a little bit as well. I only had enough content for one episode, so you know what? I'm not starting from nowhere. But, I'll give you a little rundown of what's been going on. Look, this is the spawn area. Very nice, very calm, alright, well, calm, I mean, it's quite messy, there's stuff going around everywhere. We got someone's house over there, I don't know whose house that is, but it's lovely, isn't it? That's Ledude's house over there, you can spot it in the distance, and we'll come to that one in just a second. We've got, obviously, our nether portal, some fish farms down there. I've been doing a lot of fishing this season, very nice. That is Spleck and Runeely's place over there, very nice. We've got ourselves a cheeky iron farm here, which has some great drops out of it, so that's amazing. And then just over here, let's go past the potatoes. This is Chris's place. Isn't it gorgeous? Look at that. Look at the little horses. Look inside here. It's beautiful. Also, look at the height. Look at the height I can get from this horse. Bam. Crazy. That is a 4-block high jump. Anyway, let's pop over here through this lovely little passage over the fancy bridge. And this is my place. I've done a fair amount. You know, it's not an incredible size build, but I've been doing quite a bit of work. Here's our mine. Okay, you can go down there. That's pretty boring, but I've just tried to throw storage everywhere. So this is like stone and sort of mining materials here, in these chests over here. It's all themed. Then obviously you've got some blast furnaces if you actually need them. Was it stone cutter thing? I think maybe. Then here, this is supposed to be the smeltery, so I keep all of my goods here. Obviously, I've got all my diamonds in my inventory for a little thing in a minute. This is where I keep my wood for the chopping. All right, this is our little wood chopping station. You got your wood blocks and then just stuff that's crafted out of wood in there. I'll plop those down. Then what have we got around the other side? Let's check it out. Books. Oh yeah, got some nice juicy books from the fishing. Look at that. And then some books and paper. This is just general stuff that I didn't have anywhere to put. I guess I can put the stuff in the mine now. This is Sashimi's little house. There you go. That's my horse Sashimi there. Lives in here. Got a nice little bell. Dong. And I keep all my farmed goods and all my fished goods right here. Look at that, Nautilus shells. I got 4 conduits. That is pretty damn cool, if you ask me. 4 conduits in one episode. And then this is like the base area. And this is for fishing, so I've done some fishing here. They don't have much stuff in them. Neither does that. Ooh, that's fancy. And this is where I cook my fish. But most importantly, this is where I lay down to rest at night. So I think it's just important that we take this opportunity to watch the beautiful sunset. As we prepare for an absolutely astonishing episode to come. Just look at that. Setting over the... You are so well trained. First things first, what I've wanted to do on camera, I want to get myself some good diamond gear. I've got 22 diamonds right now. I've also got 3 more, but I'm kind of just saving them for now. Let's grab my horse. And I need to pick which items I want. I don't think I want a new helmet. So that would be 8 there. Another 7, that takes us up to 15, and then 2 more there, 4 more there, sorry, 2 on each side, that takes us up to 19, and then I've got enough for a pick. I don't think I need trousers just yet. I don't think I particularly need trousers. So, maybe, okay, I'm just gonna do it. Craft a diamond chest plate, diamond boots, not all of them. I almost crafted so many diamond boots there, that would have been bad. And then let's get some sticks. I want a diamond pick there, and a diamond sword. There we go, and I've got 5 spare. Fantastic. Alright, now the goal is enchant these up. I've got 35 levels. See? And that's alright, isn't it? That's alright. Let's chuck these diamonds back in the chest and see what enchantments we can get. Chest plates. Bam! That's shocking. We got protection 4. I'm breaking 3 again. Come on, give me something good. Sweeping edge 3. That, oh my god, that's terrible. That's disgusting. These are just Mojang. Fix your game. I'm not poisoned, you're poisoned. Let's see what we can get. I think I'm gonna have to go for the boots because that just gives me unbreaking 3, and I'm really looking for efficiency, so oh, just protection 3. Fortune 3? Hey! What does it go up to? Fortune 3? I think it goes up to fortune 3, doesn't it? Come on, give me something good. Bam, bam! Woohoo! I like that. Alright, it's not quite efficiency 5, but I'll take it. You know what, I'll take it. And just for you, you demon. Slap. Evil. So, first things first. I mean, after having that poor effort in the enchantments that we got, I've slapped on a few more things. If you see here, we've got Unmending, Unbreaking, Feather Falling, Death Strider. Fantastic, alright? And also finished off this diamond pickaxe. So, you know, stuff's alright. And I've still got a mending book here. But something that I want to do, and that I've really wanted to do for so, so long, not on this season, but on everything that I've ever done, is make a bookshop. Like, I really want to make a bookshop. For enchanted books, mainly. And then also for written books. And I feel like that could be quite funny if I just write some books with random stuff in them, like stories or poems or jokes or things. I feel like that could be quite good, and just sell them for like really cheap. But yeah, I thought of a really interesting system for these books. So hear me out on this. Well, there are 3 different tiers of books. So you have books like a Piercing 3 book, that's like tier 1, okay? Then you have maybe Blast Protection 4, Looting 2, maybe that's tier 2. Then you'd have a Mending book, which is tier 3. And the system would work, you pay maybe like 1 diamond for a tier 1 book, then 2 diamonds for a tier 2 book, 4 diamonds for a tier 3 book, or you can pay 2 diamonds to get a random book, if that makes sense. But basically what I thought is just like a little bit of a gamble, so you can get the book you really want from tier 3, because nobody's really going to buy the tier 1 books, are they? You can get any book you want from tier 3, or you can risk going for a random one where you might get the perfect book you wanted for a really good price, or you might end up getting something that's like tier one and stupid that you really don't want. I feel like that could be quite a fun little trade-off there. But maybe I need to sort out the prices for them. I'll think about it, because I don't think I want it just diamonds. The first thing that needs to be done is I've just been using the community fish farm over there, but I need my own personal fish farm, which has some mega storage, so that I can just, you know, set myself fishing for as long as I like. Alright, dudes. Let's have a look down here. Look, completely inconspicuous little hole here. You can jump in, plop. And here's my fish farm. It's really not very glamorous. There's just a fence under there. And I went for a very interesting build palette for this. But, you know, all I need to do is stand here. I just chuck my rod out, hold down right click on this note block, and then it just keeps fishing for me automatically. And so I can just leave this running, go AFK, and get as much fish as I want. I'm not really looking for the fish. I'm really looking for the juicy books that you get out of it. Like, that's gonna be my main thing. One AFK session. You can probably hear from my voice that I just woke up. But I AFK'd overnight, expecting that I would probably come back to see maybe, I don't know, 3 chests full, because the server timed out. But check this out, full, goes all the way up to here. That's crazy. We got griefed, by the way. We got caught. really, I'm breaking a mending bookshop. Very nice. See, this is our competition. You see. Look at that. Hey, this is lovely. Yeah, I quite like this. Does make me wonder, where am I going to put mine up? Let's make sure it's town. This is lovely. No, Spike. Okie dokie. Look at this beautiful redstone circuit here. Spent a fair amount of time just working on this. And it's, may look messy. Actually, it doesn't even look that messy. It looks quite tidy. It's completely 4 wide all the way across, and I tried to keep it as short as possible. I think it's what, 1, 2, 3. No, it's also 4 tall. It didn't really matter how long it was. Now, this is a circuit that's going to be going inside the bookstore, and what it does is you'll see that inside these chests we have different items, and these symbolize the different types of books. So you have tier 1, tier 2, and tier 3 books. And so you pay something individually for all of them, but if I press this button here, it's going to take an item randomly from one of these chests and drop it into the barrel. There you go. Simple as that. But the real problem was getting the timing right so that the hoppers only took one item. Also, if you check at the back here, there are no items stuck in any of the hoppers. It all goes all the way through the circuit. Which is great, because I wanted everything to be on display. If there were books in here that you could see, and you're like, oh, I wonder if I could get this book in the random, but there were already items in the hopper, then that would mean when you pressed the button to randomize it, you'd always get the one inside the hopper, so you wouldn't actually see the potential books that you could get. Does that make any sense? I think that makes sense. This bookshop here is not going to be any ordinary bookshop, alright? We could just do what Rooney's done over there, and that's fine, you know? build a building, but I wanted to go a little bit more than that because we've got this lovely river here, and I thought, imagine if we did it so that it wasn't a building, it was a boat, like a barge or something, because I live very close to a river, and so you see canal boats going along all the time, and so I sort of had this idea in my mind, and that's why I wanted to keep it 4 wide, because I want it as thin as possible, have a canal boat that goes along here, and it can be like the bombastic bookstore boat or something. I don't know. I think that'll be fun. So it's going to be on that, because why not? That's original, isn't it? It doesn't get done often. We've got this river right next door, so we might as well utilize it. Alright, okay. So I've just come on, right? This has all been messed with. None of so. This is not my storage. Look, fair enough. But this is not. I've been away longer than that. What? Seriously. What the hell is that? And this is all different as well. Where's my carpet? Where's my carpet? Yeah, and I wasn't fishing anymore. Somebody's come and messed with it. And I don't appreciate that. What? Oh my god. Oh my god. What the hell is this? What the hell is this? Oh my god. Okay, I'm not that far from my base. That's alright. Do you reckon I can make this? How the hell did I get up there? This must have taken so long. Bloody hell. So did they place me so that I was fishing again? How the hell am I gonna get down? Do I risk... Do I risk jumping? I totally risk jumping, right? I totally risk jumping. Let's do it. 3, 2, 1, go. Yeah, I'll make that. No. Oh, I forgot I have legendary boots on. They didn't even take a dent. Oh my god. Thank you, Feet Savers. Damn.
Hey.
How the hell? How did you do that?
You spent like an hour moving you.
How the hell?
How do you like that? Your new fishing shoes then?
I mean, I love it.
Does it feel like home?
That's brilliant.
It did feel like home, didn't it?
That is absolutely bloody amazing. I got like this really strange feeling coming back that I've been pranked. I was just like, I know that I've been pranked. And then I went on and I was like, oh no. Oh, that's a shame because there were so many people on, that was perfect pranking opportunity. I was like, oh, they really missed out on one there. And then I checked out the storage and I was like, oh, come on, guys, like, you messed with my storage. What have you done?
Oh, so it went perfectly.
Oh my god, yeah, that was exactly so the plan
we
had.
As soon as I saw it, I started recording just to have like a little rant. It was probably good that I did because then... Oh my god, and the server didn't reset. Well done for that, because if the server had reset whilst I was in there, that would have messed it all up, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Well, you would have been still in the same room, wondering what the hell was going on with the storage.
Yeah, but whilst you were moving me over there, if it reset.
Oh. In the middle of that, that would have been problematic.
Yeah. Yes, it would. So how did you do it?
Minecarts. So because you were constantly right-clicking, we just put a minecart in front of you, and you instantly hopped on. You did break your mending rod, is the thing, so we replaced it with a new one. Because you were constantly like clicking on it, so we needed to have it perfect. That's basically it.
Oh, well thank you for the new rod, I appreciate that, but...
Yeah, it is my rod.
Very wholesome.
Was I fishing in the actual fishing farm then?
Oh yeah, you were fishing there for like a few hours now.
So you lined that up pretty well.
Yeah, we that got some impressive. We got some fishing rods from your chests and like used them as like trial rods. Hmm. So you would just break them while you were fishing away, and we could see how close you were to the actual fishing spot.
Oh,
blue.
We had a ton of fun doing that because I have a few screenshots of how the like scaffolding bridge we made looked like.
Oh, I need to see that.
Because we had a massive like roller coaster up to the hill.
Is that an SMP voice?
I'm gonna see if I can find a picture quickly. I took a few quick shots of it.
All I can see is the one of you and Chris in a boat. Oh, that's totally... What are you scaffolding there?
Uh-huh. Yeah, MLG scaffolding.
Oh my god. Yeah.
Hey Mario, would you like to get a ride?
Yes.
Alright.
Chris, get out. I'll see if I can jump in.
Alright, 5 diamonds a minute.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna turn off my
I need an inventory full of iron.
I can't get in.
Get on the scaffoldings. Climb up. Let's go. Yeah, I went near him once. But only once. So I learned my lesson after that.
3 hearts.
Oh! You mean more than that?
Okay, calm down, man.
Alright, so if you have a peek here, I have completely finished the bottom half of the boat, the dark half. There's going to be the dark half down the bottom, and then a nice red part on top. It's going to be black and red. Lovely, lovely stuff. So yeah, you may have noticed it's really long. That's kind of the point of these canal barges. They are quite long. So let's pop over, have a little peek inside. It's pretty empty, but at the back here we have all the room for our circuit, and then at the front we can have a little bit of an entrance down to it, and then we're also going to have another section of the bookshop upstairs, which will be really fun, I think. Alright, so the next bit's been done. Look at this. Bam! Circuit has been put inside. There we go, all fully working. I've not got stuff in these chests, let's throw some stuff in there. Logs, polished diorite, let's have some cobblestone. And then let's whack on the button here. Haven't worked out a proper input yet, but press the button and we get a random one. We got a log that time. What are we going to get this time? Cobblestone. Next one. More cobblestone. Very nice. Very nice. Look at that. That was actually quite quick as well. Oh, that's because it was lagging behind. What are we going to get? There we go. Polished diorite. That's more like it. Not lagging behind anymore. Hope it's not... Oh, why are you dropping out cobblestone? No! Ugh. I fixed it. I don't know how. Well, I kind of know how. I could not lead you through the entire process. But I know that I fixed it. And that's all that matters. Go away, phone. Yeah. I guess... I guess I finally got that sorted, huh? Now I just need to link this up and hope that it works. Should do, right? It should do. If it doesn't, then I'm gonna be so sad. Yeah, that's fine. Alright. Barrel there. Hopper. And then, where did my dropper go? Lost my dropper. Okay, I'll make another one. I shall put you here. Bam. So now if everything works, I just put my payment in. Now place item to pay. Click. And I get random item. And I put in item pop. Click. And I get random item. And one more. See if we can get all three. Actually, I'm just going to go till I can get a log just to make sure that it does work. So you kind of actually don't need to put the item in there. There we go. That all works out just perfectly. Apart from the fact that you don't actually need to put an item in there, you could just press the button, but I'm hoping that people are nice. There we go. All done for now. Oh, that's where I put the dropper. I was looking right at... I'm so stupid, guys. It's like almost 11 o'clock. I'm gonna go now. That's enough for me. Alright, so this boat, I mean, it's been finished for quite a while now. It's been a long time since I've come back to it, but I'm just gonna check it out now. I'll show you the insides. Alright, so this is what it looks like downstairs. I added in the decorations. This is a little book. You can read through it if you want. It's just about how to pay. I think it's 5 coal. Yeah, 5 coal for one tier, a coal block for tier 2, 3 diamonds for tier 3, and then 1 diamond for random. And I'd just like to check. Ooh, people have actually come along and bought these. Great. I love that. I'll have to check the random chest then for anything. up here, this is an unfinished area. I'm going to add one more thing in here. And I'd just like to check out... Any randoms? 5 randoms. Wow. That's pretty cool. People have done all 5. So I've not officially opened this, but I like how people have already come in and checked some stuff out. Did anybody get some of these? You're not allowed to do that. But that's Brill. Alright, I'm very happy with that. It's good that people have already found the shop and have already started buying stuff. Look at that. Look at that. We've already got some new stuff. But what is this new room for? This is going... It's going to be a written book area. So this is the enchanted book, and here I'm just going to write some really stupid little books. Some of them are going to be poems, some of them are going to be stories. They're going to be like, I don't know, I'm going to say, I'm going to say they're 5 diamonds each. Is that too expensive? I feel like people would genuinely pay that though. Maybe just like 2 diamonds each. That would be fine. But yeah, they're just gonna be silly little books. So I'm gonna have a blast writing some of those, and I'll get right back to you once I've written some. Look at that. Nice. That's not bad. I wonder if we've had any other sales. Let's check. Nobody's put stuff in there. Ooh, nobody takes these. Interesting. Let's just check. No, nothing in there. So I finished up a couple of books, and at the moment there's just 2 of them, because I couldn't think of any other things that I'd like to write, so that's what we've got. You can have a little flick through some of these. This is just a poem, which is really interesting. And then this one is just an innocent little joke book. I'm sure you can pause whenever you like and check those pages out. But yeah, this is all done, and it's clearly getting customers, even though I haven't even announced it yet. So I guess all that's left to do is head over to the Discord and chuck up an announcement. And that's it. This project is done. I can just leave it to run now, and then maybe every now and then put in a couple of new books and write some new stories, and then we're good. So, I'm glad that one's out of the way. That took an awfully long time. I've had other episodes being recorded during this, but I've got to release this one first. So, look forward to that. I've got tons more content to put out there. So, thank you for watching this episode. If you enjoyed it, please remember to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already. Some awesome videos like this, and I'm really bad at my outro now, so forgive me. But thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.